Oftentimes we look at false teachers and false churches and we look at their popularity and we say, these things are happening because we are failing in our discipleship. It's not necessarily the case. And I'm asked that question, I'm frequently asked that question. Why is it? Why is it that God allows these false teachers to prosper, these false churches to grow? Why is it? If I was God, I would just like, it's mushroom cloud, man. Just right there in the middle of TV, somebody opens their mouth and tells a lie and then ashes. Why? Why do these false teachers prosper? Why do these false churches grow? The answer is because the Bible is true. Listen to it again. For the time is coming when people will not endure sound teaching. Having itching ears, they will accumulate for themselves or heap up for themselves teachers to suit their own passions and will turn away from listening to the truth and will wander off into myths. False teachers will prosper and false churches will grow. And it will happen because the Bible is true. And how do we respond? By continuing to preserve and proclaim the gospel. And by continuing to endure the suffering that will come inevitably as a result. And one of the ways that this leads to that kind of suffering is this. There is a world out there that hates the gospel because they love their sin. And we're seeing this right now today. They hate the gospel because they love their sin. And the gospel is proclaimed, but then there are false teachers who are scratching itching ears. And for example, same-sex marriage. There are people out there who are now moving away from preserving the truth and basically are saying, you know what? I am a Christian and Christianity is wrong. I am embracing this lifestyle. And the world says, yes, the enlightened ones. And the end result is those who are holding fast to the truth are now further marginalized as people say, this is real Christianity because they're open, affirming, and tolerant. And you are absolutely not like Jesus because you are a hateful bigot. Anybody heard that? Anybody been? Okay. This is a prime example of what we're talking about. A real, right here, right now example of what we're talking about. What are you going to do? And so what is desperately needed in our age, as in the apostolic age, is those who will preserve and proclaim the gospel and in turn endure the suffering that will come inevitably as a result of doing so.
False teachers are God's judgment on people who don't want God, but in the name of religion plan on getting everything their carnal heart desires. That's why a Joel Osteen is raised up. Those people who sit under him are not victims of him. He is the judgment of God upon them because they want exactly what he wants and it's not God. And you can line them all up along with him. That's where it is. For ourselves, teachers in accordance to their own desires. So you get a Benny Hinn in there who all he wants to do is tell you you're going to have a Mercedes-Benz. Those people aren't victims. God's judgment upon them. They want what he wants, and so they accumulate him to themselves along with all those other teachers because they teach exactly what they want. Do you see that?
That's because they hardened their hearts against God. They rejected the truth of God. And this is one of the most frightening facts in the spiritual life, that if we persistently and obstinately reject the truth of God that's brought to us, God will withdraw from us the ability to understand the truth. And God will open up to us some kind of spirit that will take in, that's the spirit of error and deception. I think that's one of the most terrible judgments that can come upon those who deliberately reject God's revealed truth. And it says in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 10 and following, he will come with all the deception of wickedness for those who perish because they did not receive the love of the truth so as to be saved. Isn't that frightening? If we don't receive the love of the truth, then God is going to deal with us. and we're going to come under deception. And then it says, and for this reason God will send upon them a deluding influence, so that they might believe what is false, in order that they all may be judged who did not believe the truth, but took pleasure in wickedness. I believe that is already happening. I believe God is permitting a deluding spirit to come upon various sections of the church which have deliberately rejected the revealed truth of God, especially upon ministers and leaders who are responsible for these errors. And when that deluding spirit comes upon any person, that person can no longer see the truth. They lose the ability.
Paul was talking to Timothy as a minister. He says, if people are not willing to change, leave them to themselves. How much time is wasted in contemporary Christianity by counseling people who will never change? So I believe that's all part of what Paul said to Timothy. Leave them alone. Don't waste time on people who will not change. If a person is willing to change, God will go to endless lengths to help them. But if they want to stay the way they are, God leaves them to themselves.